This video tutorial I will explain how to read HTTP post request body using request body annotation in Spring Boot RESTful Web Service. Here I have defined a class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age and salary, and getter and setter methods for these four properties. Here I have defined a class employee controller, which is REST controller, and it has create employee method, which accept employee object. And to call this method, we have to send request to this URI, and HTTP method should be post, and this method produces either XML or JSON, and this method consumes either XML or JSON. And here I have applied request body annotation. So when HTTP request comes to this method, Spring Boot automatically converts employee JSON payload or employee XML payload to employee object. Then I am printing the employee object here and setting the ID in the employee object using some random value, and returns employee object to the calling client. Now I am going to start this Spring Boot application in debug mode. Now I am going to send request to this URL, and HTTP method is post. Click on body, select raw, and here select JSON, and here put the employee JSON. And click on send. Request reached here, and the employee JSON payload is converted to employee object. Then setting the random ID and returns employee object back to the client. And here we got the output. The output is in the XML format. Next, what I am going to do is, I am going to send employee XML payload instead of JSON payload. Select XML. And here I have put XML payload. Click on send. And request reached here, and employee XML payload is converted to employee object. And I am setting employee ID, randomly some number I am setting. Then returns employee object back to the calling client. And here I got the output. Here you can see we got output in XML format. Instead, I want to get output in JSON format. If you notice, this endpoint can either produce XML output or JSON output. So what we have to do to get JSON output is, go to the headers and add accept header. And here we have to specify value as application/json. Now send the request. And request reached here. And here you can see, now we got JSON output. Suppose I want to get XML output. Instead of JSON, here provide XML, application/XML. Click on send. And here we got the output in XML format. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.